Hi, my name's William. We're in the strawberry field. Today is April 19th, and we're gonna be talking about the progress of the strawberries. So this variety is Sweet Sensation, and we talked about last video, they're already ripe and fruiting, so we've got a lot of red fruits there. And then this variety, Chandler, is a little later, and you can see it's loaded with a ton of immature fruits, and we've got some that are turning pink, starting to turn red. So these Chandlers are ripe now too, and the Sweet Sensation are ripe. So both of the strawberries are ripe. This whole field is full of strawberries. You'll have to come pick a basket for yourself. Okay, so strawberries are divided into three main groups. You have the first type of strawberry, which is June bearing. And as the name implies, they bear in June, but in North Carolina, they bear in April and May because we bloom earlier. But up north, they would bear in June, and they make one large flush of fruits, and then that's it, they're done for the summer. And the next type of strawberries is called everbearing, and everbearing strawberries, like Sweet Sensation, will make one large crop in the summer, and then they'll make another smaller crop later in the summer into fall. And then the third type of strawberry is called day neutral. Day neutral strawberries don't care what type of day length it is, if it's long days or short days in the winter. If the temperature is warm, they will make flowers and fruits. We don't have any day neutral strawberries here, and you could only really grow day neutral strawberries in a greenhouse in North Carolina, which we don't do. So we have June bearing and ever bearing, but both of these strawberries will continue to fruit until the end of May when it gets too hot. When we buy the tips from Canada, from Nova Scotia, day length is getting shorter and the temperatures are getting colder, and then that triggers them to set blossoms. So when we buy the tips from Canada, they already have these flower blossoms set on them, but they haven't turned into flowers yet. They grow over the winter and they continue to have those flower blossoms, and then in the spring they emerge. But on these June-bearing strawberries, there is a set amount of flower blossoms on here. There's only a finite amount. And then once all those have bloomed, that's it for the season until next season when they would bloom again. But they're annual, so they only bloom once. And then the everbearing, they do kind of the same thing where they'll have a finite amount that bloom in spring, and then they will reset more flower buds in the crowns, and then they'll bloom again in the fall. And then the day neutrals, they just don't care. They do whatever they want as long as it's warm. So those are kind of confusing, but this is like the main way strawberries grow. And then they also have everbearing, but we won't get that crop in the fall because it'll be too hot in the summer, they'll die. So in colder climates up north, or maybe even in the mountains of North Carolina, they will sometimes keep strawberries for multiple years. Usually that'll be in a different system called a matted row. It won't be on these plastic beds. They'll be in the ground, in the soil, which they are now, but they'll be in a matted row basically. And that's a perennial system. They'll keep the strawberries year round. The reason we don't do that here is because it's a little lower yielding and it's difficult to keep the strawberry plants alive throughout the summer. It's very hot in the summer in North Carolina and it can get very dry. There's a lot of disease pressure and the strawberries just don't like it at all. So it's a difficult time to keep them alive during the summer, and it's better to just kill them at the end of the season and then reset with clean, fresh plant material, disease-free, and then you have strawberries every year on plastic rows like this.